In the previous video, we have finished the step 1, means up to sending the purchase order we discussed. Now assume that you have sent the purchase order and the book will reach library after 30 days. So first, after 30 days when you receive the packet of books along with the invoices, first log in with your admin ID and password and get your admin interface of the Koha, and then again go to the acquisition. So again I am going to do the search. Again I am going to search Bimal Books because I received the packet of Bimal Books, and then I click on search. So it will show me the vendor detail and also the order detail which was sent to this vendor 30 days back. So it will take you directly to the next screen. You can see here, when you get this screen, you can match this order number with your invoice. In invoice also it must be written. So you will come to know that, okay, yes, this particular purchase order number is listed here. So what you have to do, you have to receive the book detail in software. You have already received the invoice and book manually, and you have checked, you found everything is okay, correct. You did all the processing, you entered all the accession number in the accession register, you have finished everything. Now you same thing you have to follow in the computer, means Koha. So the next option will be, you have to receive the shipment in Koha. And here when the screen is open, you have to enter the invoice number which is given to which is already given in the invoice sent by the vendor. So here vendor invoice Vimal, for example Vimal 1 or 01 or V1, I'll mention V1 because purchase order number is same, so you may get confused. So invoice number is V1, on which day it was shipped, means this invoice date. And then you have to select the particular fund from which it will be deducted and click on next. So it will take you to the next window where it will show the title against the purchase order. You can see here the title is shown, and now you have to click on receive option. See, there are so many things here. It is showing title, everything, price detail, or from which fund it will be deducted, what was the purchase order number, and all these. If you want to cancel order also, you can cancel order from here, but generally this does not happen. If it happens, then you have to cancel from here also. So you receive the book in Koha and click on receive option. So it will take you to the next window where you have to enter the accession number and also the price detail as per the invoice sent by the vendor. Yes, it has taken us to next screen, and you can observe here at the left side this is the catalog detail, and at the right side it is the accounting detail. If you remember when I was discussing about the Koha administration, we were talking about this cataloging detail and this particular item. So here you can see that you can add the accession number. For example, I add accession number and then I have to choose the item type, in which item type you are going to add, and then click on add item. Now you can notice that it has been added with the accession number this, and right side you were supposed to receive one item and you have already received one item. For example, you have any discrepancy in the price as per the invoice, you can make changes here. And here also you have an opportunity to change the budgeted, because finally it is going to be deducted from here. So far you have been selecting the fund detail at different places, like once we selected at the time of purchase, then we selected at the time of processing invoice, but now it is finally deducting from the budget head. So you have to select it carefully and then click on save option. So this particular detail will get saved in database and you will be taken to the next screen. See here, it has saved the data, and now finally click on finish receiving. So as soon as you click on finish receiving, our second step gets over here, and we have successfully processed the invoice, added the accession detail and also the catalog detail, pricing detail, everything in the software. So the second step gets over here. Now the third step will be when you send, after this, when you send the invoice to the account section and they make the payment, after making the payment, they will update you, and when they update you, you have to open the invoice again. You have to, okay, let me explain in the next video so you will not get confused. So this second step is over here. We will discuss in the next video how to update the payment detail when you get confirmation from the account section and close the invoice.